Gooey Butter Cheesecake? Hey everybody, my name is Lindsay and I am with Perfectly Pastry. Who is Perfectly Pastry? We are a local bakery in Waterloo, Illinois. How are you doing? If you're watching me live, use a heart. Let me know you're watching me live. If you're watching me on replay, use hashtag replay. And if it's the first time you've ever caught me live, use the number one. Let me know, hey girl, it's the first time I've ever caught you live. How are you doing this week? Yep, it is spring break for me and my kiddos this week. So I'm gonna make this, which I say a lot, short, sweet, and to the point so that I can get back to hanging out with my kids. We've been doing things like going to the park and stuff. We have this really cool playground that just opened up. We haven't even had the chance to go. So we went and had a lunch there and played at the playground. It's so cool. It's got like this huge castle. The only thing that I have to say is one of the other playgrounds that I take the kids to, they have it's called You Can Dig It. So like there's a whole area where there's like artifacts buried in like this pebbly rocky sand stuff, and the kids can dig in there and find it. And because I live in Florida, it rains a lot, so it's nice to go to that park because we can still play and sit underneath the like protective awning. I don't know, whatever. It's like inside a building, but like there's air circulating. So I guess it's technically outside. What is it called? I don't know. It's like got a shed. Can I call it a shed? A shed over the playground? A roof? I don't know. Whatever. Anyways, so it's got that to keep us out of the elements, you know, like when it's raining. And there have been plenty of times that we've been at that playground and it just like opened up and rained on us, right? Because I mean, I said we live in Florida. So when we were at this other playground, I realized, A, all the parent seating inside the playground, because there's like a fence so the kids can't get out. There's no shade, which means it's gonna be really hot this summer. So I have to think about that because a lot of times I'll go and work from my computer and let the kids play because you know they want to be outside running around. There are some like pavilions next to it. That was the word. I guess you're under a pavilion. There you go. And it had like picnic benches and stuff, but you can't see inside where the kids are playing. So I was like, I don't know. We'll have to see, but it was a lot of fun. So we're excited because we're actually getting a new community center with it. So where I live, the community center that is closest to me, I was gonna say is about 30 minutes away, but that's not true. There is one other one. I just don't like to go there as much. It is probably like 15, 20 minutes away. This one is you like come out of my neighborhood, go down the street, around the corner, and it's right there. And there's a park center, and they're about to put a water park in there. Like we're really excited about it, so we don't have to like hike all the way back to the other one. So that is what we have been doing. We went exploring to check it out. My eldest, she didn't want to go, but then when she didn't go, she was like, oh, I'm so bummed I missed like how cool it looked. The little girls were like talking about how fun it was. So we're really excited about that. We were gonna go swimming and stuff, but it's actually been pretty rainy here, so that's kind of been a bummer. All right, so we'll go ahead and we will get out some of the housekeeping for the week. I want everybody to know that we are going to have a new flavor of muffin in the shop this week. We are having a lemon blackberry muffin. That will be towards the end of the week, I think, is when we're going to actually have it in the shop. So keep looking out for that. Watch our social media. We share it on social media and things like that. So you can keep checking back. Now, if you are on our social media, you did see, if you look at stories, which by the way, I was not a fan of stories when it first came out. I was just like, I don't understand why I'm looking at stories. Obviously, as I have gotten into TikTok and Reels, like stories are no longer a weird thing, you know, those small little clips. And so I now am like, oh, I'm gonna check out their stories. I don't wanna look at my Instagram feed. I'm just gonna watch stories for now. So if you like started to do that like me, you will see that we did post that we have a new Berry Delight cheesecake. So we wanna invite you to stop by the shop and get your piece of our Berry Delight cheesecake. All right, speaking of cheesecake, that's my segue into the topic today. So I was on the phone earlier with my sister, and we were like talking about some of the things that I could go over and talk with you guys on my live. Because, like I said before, when you go live weekly, sometimes you're just like, what should I talk about? So what I decided is, since I made a post on Facebook and Instagram about our different types of cheesecake, I should probably tell you where gooey butter cheesecake came from, because we didn't actually start out with gooey butter cheesecake. That is something that we developed pretty quickly, though. Like, oddly enough, we had somebody order gooey butter cakes through our wholesale, and we started making that. And when my mom was making them, we would talk about the product, and she'd like explain to me like what goes into it, how the process works, and all of those things. And she kept saying, you know, gooey butter cake is just like cheesecake. Like it's very similar to cheesecake, like really similar. And so she got to thinking, and we were talking, and she was like, you know, why wouldn't we try to build our cheesecake on top of a gooey cake crust? She's like, you know, gooey butter is really decadent. It's dense. And so some people are like, oh, it's a little too sweet for me, but I really like it. Like my sister and I love gooey butter cookies. Like those are our favorite kind of cookies. And so it's because they're not quite as sweet as gooey butter cake. But like, that's the thing. Not everybody wants to do gooey butter cake. So we thought, why don't we take the crust and then build our cheesecake on top of that? Like, it was like this weird, like, you know, I don't know anybody else who's doing that. And that sounds really, really good. And so my mom's like, all right, let's try it. It went over crazy. Like, it went over so well. Like, it blew our minds. Like, we were like, when we were in the commercial kitchen over there, we would have some of the other food vendors in there. And we were like, all right, guys, you know, try these for us. Give us your opinion. Let us know what you think. And they were like, oh my gosh, that is so good. Like, you just used gooey cake bottom. And we're like, yeah. So those of you who are watching this and you're not from St. Louis and you're like, what are you talking about? Gooey cake is a traditional dessert in St. Louis. It's very, very popular. I'm not a baker, so I'm probably not the best one to talk about this, but I'm going to attempt it anyways. So it started with a baker was going to make something. Listen to me. The baker was going to make something, and then they like didn't have enough of something. So then they added a bunch of other somethings, and there you go. That's how it was born. I probably should have prepped a little more for that one. I'll have to ask my mom. But if I'm not mistaken, it was like somebody accidentally over added too much powdered sugar. Okay. Because gooey butter cake has a lot of powdered sugar compared to cheesecake. And so somebody accidentally added way too much. They went ahead and were like, forget it. We've already made it. We're serving it. And people were like, this is crazy. This is so good. We love it, blah, blah. And it just became this tradition. A lot of restaurants, a lot of bakeries in the St. Louis area, if you're not from around here, offer gooey butter. So we were like, all right, let's do something better. Like, our cheesecakes are really amazing. We love our cheesecake. Let's throw it on gooey cake bottoms. And it went over exceptionally well. So if you've not ever tried it, I want to invite you to stop by the shop and definitely give it a try. We just don't do traditional graham cracker crust. You can get cheesecake with graham cracker crust almost anywhere. And so we are like, we're going to offer you something different, something unique. It's definitely unique to the area because, like I said, a lot of other cities and states are like, I don't even know what you're talking about. Like, what is gooey butter? We have friends in a different state and they were like, what is this gooey butter I see you talking about all the time? So we went ahead and shipped it to him to try. We're like, just try it. And he was like, oh my gosh, that's so good. And we're like, we know it is really, really good. He is like everybody else, he's like, man, you can't eat all that piece in one sitting. And we're like, we know, because we always believe in giving you the value for your buck, right? So we have really giant slices in our shop that we sell. And he was like, oh, it is so good. And unfortunately, we can't ship the cheesecake to him because it needs to remain, it's temperature control. So anybody who's taken SurfSaver or if you're in the restaurant industry, you know that we have to really watch time and temperature. And cheesecake is one of those things that we just can't guarantee its like shipping success. I don't know if that's the way I would say it, but you know, we just want to make sure that we aren't taking it out of you know, the time temperature. So we can't ship it. So he was like, oh my gosh, I can only imagine what the cheesecake tastes like. And I was like, yeah, you should come up this summer and try a piece. He's like, I actually might have to do that because it was really, really good. So yes, that is actually how we came about the gooey butter cheesecake. And it's funny because I remember as a kid, like I grew up in Texas and I obviously came back to Missouri all the time because that's where my family is from. And I always had gooey butter cake and cookies and stuff like that. Like, I didn't know that it was a St. Louis thing when I was younger because, you know, I was young and I didn't pay attention. It wasn't until about high school that I started talking to friends and I'm like, oh, yeah, my favorite dessert is this. They're like, what is that? And I'm like, wait, what? My mom was like, yeah, Lindsay, that's just a St. Louis thing. Like, not everybody knows about gooey butter cake. And I was like, oh, I did not know that. Yeah. And obviously, as I have gone through the process of opening the bakery with my mom and my sister, I've really come to understand like that people really didn't know what that was. And that we get so many people like, oh my gosh, like this cheesecake is so good. And we're like, we know, like those gooey cake bottoms are just, they just make those cheesecakes between that and the cheesecake and the topping. Like, if you haven't tried one, I highly, highly suggest you do. Anyways, so That is all I have today. Like I said, I was going to make it quick, short, sweet, and to the point. My kiddos are at home, and we are going to probably go check out another playground. They're asking if we could go for a walk, so we'll be doing those kind of things today. I do know that you guys have a really nice weather up there, so I'm really excited about that. We were talking to them, and I was like, oh, your guys' weather is almost as warm as ours, so I know you guys are out there enjoying the day, which is great. But I'm going to go ahead and hop off of here. If you guys are watching us on Facebook, then you should be liking and following us on Facebook. Facebook's not really your thing, but you're on other social media. So are we. We are at Perfectly Pastry Bakery on social media, but all the other social media, we are at Perfectly Pastry. All right, guys, I'm going to let you get back to the rest of your week, and I will see you again here next week. All right, talk to you later.